A and B, so now P of A equals to we have what P of B is equal to 7 and 10, and what P of A union B is 4 and 5. Now, let's find P of A intersection B. What? Find P of A intersection B. And remember that in probability to have P of A union B is the same thing as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So therefore means P of A intersection B is supposed to be made the subject of formula. So I have P of A intersection B equals to P of A plus P of B minus P of A union B. Which is going to give us a half plus 7 and 10 minus 4 and 5. So it's the same thing like 5 and 10 plus 7 minus 8, all around 10. Which will give us 12, 4 and 10, which is 2 and 5. So P of A intersection B, is equals to 2 and 5. Now I'm being asked to show that A and B are neither mutually exclusive or independent. For mutually exclusive events, are supposed to have P of A intersection B is equal to 0. Means they have no intersection. And here we see that P of A intersection B in our case is different from 0, which therefore implies A and B are mutually exclusive. Okay, now for independent events, we ought to have P of A intersection B. It's supposed to be P of A times P of B. We see that P of A intersection B now times B, which is equal to a half times 7 and 10, giving us 7 and 20, which is different from P of A intersection B. So therefore means that A and B are independent. So that's all what we need to show. Okay. On the second part of the question, the say bag contains 3 green balls and 5 red balls. 2 balls are selected randomly in succession and without displacement. Draw a probability diagram to show the possible outcome. So we have this. So first of all, each time we're having this, please, it's always good to draw a tree diagram. So here, so we have green and red. So we can put here green and red. I'll put red up and green down. So to get red, I can have the probability of having red is 3 on 5. 3 and 8 rather, because the total number of balls are 8 balls, 3 plus 5 balls. So I have green ball, we have 5 on 8. And let them select again, we take because it's the first outcome. The second outcome, now we have, we want to choose another red ball. If you have to press another red ball, see the number of balls have reduced, the number of red balls will be 2 and 7, because the total number of balls have dropped to 7, and then the number of red balls have reduced since we are taking one ball there. If it's a green ball, I want to have 5 and 7. And later on, this is our way to wrap red and green. If the first time we are choosing a green ball, to choose a red ball last time will be 2 on 8, 2 on 7, and then it will be 3 on 7 rather. And then if you choose a green ball the second time, you're going to have 4 on 7. So those are it. So we see that when they say without replacement, it means the total number of balls is supposed to drop at each level. It will be a 10 possibility, the number of balls will be 6. and so on and so forth. Now they say B, we should find the probability that all balls are red, that means the two balls drawn are red. So we're going to find P of red, red. We want to go to the branch of the tree where we have red, red, and this corresponds to this branch. So we're going to have 3 on 8 times 2.7. Please don't add probabilities, you multiply them. So we're going to have 6 on 56. So we can simplify this, we're going to have on 4, we're going to have 3 on 68. That's the probability of red, red. So the probability that at least one is red. The probability that at least one drone is red. So the probability of at least one red, probability of at least one red is equals to, simply equals to 1 minus probability of no red. No red. And this is equivalent to 1 minus the probability of green, green. It's 1 minus this. The probability 1 minus this. So I'm going to have here 1 minus 5, 8 times 4 and 7. So I'm going to have here 1 minus 5 on 14, which gives us 9 on 14. The probability of at least one red, 9 on 14. It's also the same thing. If it doesn't matter to use this formula, you will still do the same thing. You just come to everywhere you have red. So this is still the same thing as P of at least red. You can do it by an alternative method. Well, here P of at least one red is the same thing as P of, you go to anywhere that you find red. Yeah, P of red, it will be P of red, red. Plus P of red, green, plus P of green, red. So P of red, red is the multiplication of, so that one are going to have 3 on 8 times 2 on 7, plus P of red, green. So we're going to have 3 on 8 times 5 on 7, plus 5 on 8 times 3 on 7. So if you do have the same thing, you're going to find that you're going to have 9 on 14 as we had in the other case.
So that's all about the question. What you want, what you want.